bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? Jesus said to them, amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, unlike your ancestors who ate and still died. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The second Sunday after Pentecost every year is the feast, the Solemnity, the Body and Blood of Christ, also known or called Corpus Christi. And this gospel passage we just heard is what's known as the Bread of Life Discourse. It's in John's Gospel, chapter 6. And if you read the entire chapter, there's a line in that chapter in which, because of this teaching, accepted his death on our cross. And then rising from his tomb, he conquered sin and death for us. But he doesn't want us to ever forget that. He does not want us to forget that saving act that redeems us, that saving act that ultimately gets us to heaven. And so before he suffered and died, with his apostles, he took bread, blessed it, broke it, and said, "This is my body, given up for you." And similarly, taking the cup filled with wine, he said, "This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Never wanting us to forget what he did on the cross, he gave us the Eucharist at the Last Supper, which always is pointing to the cross. His body, his blood shed for us. And he said, "Do this in memory of me." We gather at the Mass to celebrate this most saving act of what Jesus did on the cross. And we celebrate often in this life to never forget what he did, and that most perfect sacrifice to get us to heaven, to give us eternal life. I have to admit, one of the hardest parts of the time when we couldn't celebrate Mass publicly was not being able to be with you, to be with the people of our parishes, to be with the body of Christ. I was fortunate in that as a priest, I was able to celebrate Mass every day. Some days, a couple of times, to fulfill the intentions that were being offered in all of our Masses. And so, when the time came that we were going to be able to open up our churches, I was excited. I was excited to be able to see the people, but I was also very excited, and at the same time thinking, we're not going to have enough room. We're not going to have enough room because people want Jesus. People want to receive Holy Communion. And I have to admit, I really sense that in our area of the world, our area of the diocese, that we were not going down the path of the statistics. In the United States, over 70% of Catholics do not believe in the real presence of the Eucharist. They do not believe that Jesus is present, body, blood, soul, and divinity in the Holy Eucharist. Over 70%. And I really sense, as we were reopening, that that's not the case here. That's why we added weekday Masses. That's why we tried to do the Masses in the biggest church. points to the reality of that statistic. Because if we really believe that Jesus, the Son of God, our Savior, our Messiah, is so present to us in the Eucharist that we actually get to receive Him, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. We believe that. And we would be so hungry to receive our Lord. Each Saturday morning, for the last several months since this virus stuff started, Archbishop Lucas has been doing a Zoom conference with us priests of the Diocese of Lincoln and Omaha. And so, except for two Saturdays, last Saturday with our ordination in Omaha, a couple Saturdays before the ordination of the Lincoln priests, each Saturday morning at 9 o'clock, as many as possible log in. The bishop gives us some announcements, but the majority of the 30 minutes is him shepherding, him giving a reflection, sometimes on the upcoming gospel. That's what he did today, focusing on the solemnity of Corpus Christi. And one of the things that he reminded us this morning is that part of the statistic, people not believing in the real presence, is probably connected to not first having a personal relationship with Jesus, not having personally encountered how much Jesus loves them, not having personally encountered Jesus' mercy for them, Jesus' desire for them to be filled with joy, Jesus' desire not having encountered life and abundance because of our Lord. And that's at the heart of what you're going to hear from me, and it's going to sound like a broken record, but I've been saying it already. As a parish, as a group of parishes, we have to help each other Together we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
A mystery of faith.
spiritually into my heart, I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Our prayer for the intercession of Saint Joseph during this time. To you, O blessed Joseph, do we come in our tribulation. Through that charity which bound you to the Immaculate Virgin, Mother of God, and through the paternal love with which you embrace the child Jesus, we humbly beg you graciously to regard the inheritance which Jesus Christ has purchased by his blood, and with your power and strength to aid us in our necessities. O most loving Father, ward off from us every contagion of error and corrupting influence. O our most mighty protector, be propitious to us, and from heaven assist us in our struggle with the power of darkness. And as once you rescued the child Jesus from deadly peril, so now protect God's children from the snares of the enemy and from all adversity. Shield too each one of us by your constant protection. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you for joining us at Mass this evening. If you're on live stream, we will return tomorrow at 9:30 a.m. God bless you.